Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Ummatul Muslimin. Inshallah, for today's synopsis, we'll be looking at the last quarter of the ninth juz of the Quran and the tenth juz of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins this portion of the Quran by describing the believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them as such, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهِ. The believers are such that when they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ, their hearts become heavy. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ, when the verses of the Qur'an, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's verses, His signs, His ayat, are mentioned or recited to them, زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا, their iman, their faith, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increases. وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ, and they put their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ummatul Muslimin, the question that you and I need to be asking ourselves is, where do we or what do we draw our inspiration from? You see, with the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, the Quran was sufficient. They were in need of guidance. They would open the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, consult Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's book, and that was enough for them. We ask ourselves a question. When we are in need of guidance today, where do we look? Do we look at the Quran, or do we consult other sources besides the Quran? This is an important question you and I need to ask each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, moving on further, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of the blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ, that as far as those people are concerned who were alive during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not send down punishment as long as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was among them. This was the blessing that Allah had given them. But there is a further blessing for the believers of that time and the believers to come until the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not send down His punishment as long as people continue to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, if a person wants to avoid, if we as an ummah, as a nation, want to avoid the wrath and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all we need to do is continuously repent and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next juz, in the 10th juz of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of an important issue regarding our social welfare. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ وَاصْبِرُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about fighting and bickering and arguing unnecessarily amongst each other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this reduces your strength. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, that your strength will disappear from you and you will be looked at as weak people. And you look at our societies today, this is a reality where people begin to fight and bicker and quarrel unnecessarily amongst one another. You find that there is no unity amongst people. There is no unity that remains. And a nation in which no unity remains is a nation that is weak and a nation that will crumble. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us strong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of an important issue in the next chapter, and that is Surah At-Tawbah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention with regards to the Muslimin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again referring to our communities and our societies. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that believers are protectors of one another. And you look at the Quran, in different places this is mentioned in different ways, that as long as there are believers around, they will always be there to protect one another. If a group of people are going astray, you find a group of people that are on the right path, A group of believers that are on the right path will come out and try and rectify their wrong or bring them back to the straight path. So, and this is the declaration that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes in the Quran, that the believing men and the believing women are protectors of one another. They are the ones that keep each other's faith intact. Our faith, sometimes you find that you might lack in faith in certain aspects, but simply looking at another Muslim doing them, our iman increases and we get more encouragement to do that. And this shows us that we are far better off encouraging one another than condemning one another. Usually we get, what happens is a person falls into the wrong thing and unfortunately we end up condemning that person, not understanding that we can get much more far and we can achieve much more by encouraging one another. With that, I conclude. Jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.